Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. I've been getting a lot of email in the last 2 days about recording on the Edison Cylinder Phonograph. And there's people that are beginning to record on their cylinder phonographs and with mixed results. Some people, in fact, most people are finding that recording on the Edison Cylinder Phonograph is not as easy as you think it is. Most of the recorders that are available have been abused. That's really not the correct word. Neglected for the last 100 years. And they just don't work very well, period. They just don't. And you can't judge a recorder, especially if you're shopping for one on eBay, by what it looks like. The only way to test a recorder is to test it. If it makes a good recording, it's a good recorder. If it doesn't, it isn't. It's that simple. Usually it's a matter of adjustment. In a lot of cases, I got an email tonight, a gentleman named Peter. He's up in Canada, and he's been making some recordings, and it looks like he bought a recorder, and the stylus had come off and been re-glued in the wrong place. It doesn't take very much to put it in the wrong place, and unless the stylus is adjusted correctly in the right place on the diaphragm, the results are mediocre at best. And you also get a high-pitched squeal, and I know this from experience. And that is an oscillation caused by the stylus being at the wrong angle, and rather than smoothly cutting the wax, it begins to vibrate. And it's a self-energizing process. It causes the diaphragm to vibrate, which in turn imparts the vibration to the stylus, which is imparting the vibration to the wax, which is being fed back to the stylus and back to the diaphragm, and it just goes, and it sounds, it's a terrible high-pitched squeech, a screech. It sounds kind of like feedback, but it isn't. And it's just the angle of the stylus is wrong for where it's actually touching the wax, and it's beginning to vibrate. It's an easy adjustment to make. Usually it requires pulling the stylus off of the diaphragm, realigning it, and then gluing it back, and I use white glue, or you can use carpenter's wood glue. It makes a very, very quick drying, nice bond that you can pull back off again. You want to be careful with the adhesive you use. The original adhesive was shellac, which is why they've broken off over the years. The stylus has come loose from the diaphragm. If you use super glue, it creates such a tight bond that usually when you pull the stylus off, you run the risk of delaminating the mica diaphragm or breaking it completely. Once the diaphragm's broken, that's it. You have to now find a replacement. They're not easy to find. These recorders on eBay are expensive. I mean, you're talking between $100 and $200. And the average price is $150 to $175 for a recorder. And you take some photos of it and put it on eBay, and you have absolutely no idea what kind of recording it's going to make. These were all handmade, no two sound the same, and the only way to test the recorder is to make a recording. That is it. That's the only definitive answer of how a recorder works, is what kind of recording it makes. But in any case, I got an email asking me to do a recording with the Canophonic voice recorder with a recording horn rather than using the speaking tube. Now, the average person does not have a speaking tube, obviously. I didn't have one either. I had to make one. Maybe I'll do a video on making speaking tubes. A recording horn, on the other hand, you can make a fairly decent recording. This is a custom-made recording horn that I made out of poster board, and this works exceptionally well. But you can make a fairly decent recording with any reasonably straight-sided horn. A witch's hat horn makes a fair recording. Something that actually works quite well is the horn for the Gem, that little straight cone black horn with a single stripe around it. That makes a fairly efficient recording horn. You can also use the Walmart plastic funnel. That makes an exceptionally good recording horn, surprisingly. It really does. It also makes a very good playback horn. But in this case, I got an email asking you to do a recording with the Canophonic voice recorder with a recording horn rather than a speaking tube so they could hear what the difference is. Now the difference, I can tell you exactly what the difference will be. A speaking tube produces a very loud, crisp, bright, very precise recording of the voice. Because, first of all, remember, this is the entire recording process is being powered by sound waves and air pressure. So when you're using a speaking tube, the distance is very small, the diameter is very small, and so you're really concentrating these sound waves on the diaphragm of the recorder. It only captures short waves. It's so short it cannot capture bass waves. Bass waves are long. And the recording with a speaking tube will always be higher pitched and louder because you have no bass waves in it at all. However, recording with a recording horn, this is 28.5 inches long with a 4.5 inch diameter opening. Now, I made this out of poster board, and the bell itself is actually a sour cream container with the bottom cut out of it, glued into this tube. And this is just one single piece of poster board, got it at Walmart, it's $1.98. You roll it into a cone, and of course it comes out pointed at the end, so you have to cut it off. Tapers down to 1/2 inch on this end. It was about 5 inches on this end, and I stuck the sour cream container in it with the bottom cut off and glued it in position. Now the horn itself is just rolled and glued, and then I put blue painter's tape down the seam. And then I sprayed 5 coats of heavy textured paint on. This is actually Rust-Oleum textured paint. And it is really solid, so it has no resonance. The sound waves go through it. It doesn't vibrate itself. It allows the sound waves to pass through it without adding anything from the horn. One thing that you do capture in a longer horn is longer waves. And so your recorder sound, or your recording sounds fuller because it's much deeper. You have more of the spectrum of frequencies captured in this horn. So a recording with a speaking tube will be higher pitched and louder and brighter. Recording with a recording horn will be fuller. It won't be as bright or as clear because the sound waves are traveling in a longer distance, more frequencies, and it simply doesn't compress them as much as a speaking tube. I prefer the speaking tube. If you want to make a really nice voice recording, use a speaking tube. If you want to record a group of people, use a recording horn. They can just come up and talk directly into it and just have them lined up and move on their way. I just wanted to do a recording with a recording horn with a Canophonic recorder. Now, I've done some recordings with a recording horn in the past, but I haven't used the Canophonic voice recorder, I don't think. I've used other recorders. But I wanted you to see, and in response to this email, what the Canophonics, the voice recorder, sounds like with a recording horn. So it won't sound, I don't think it sounds as good. It makes a loud, clear recording, but I think the speaking tube works much better. So in any case, the machine is wound, at least I think it is. I'm recording on the standard B. Yeah, it's wound enough. I just shaved and trimmed an Edison Edifone black wax cylinder. I've installed the Canophonic voice recorder, and the nice thing about the voice recorder is, of course, you don't have to yell. I can talk in a normal tone of voice, just like I am now, and with a recording horn, you can speak a bit louder. Now, with an Edison recorder, you have to yell into this thing. With a Canophonic voice recorder, you don't. I'll just talk into it, and the recording should still be crisp and clear and bright, but it will be much deeper and fuller because the recording horn is able to capture more of the longer waves. So, machine's up to speed. As soon as I drop the stylus, the recording will begin, and just a straight recording with the recording horn. Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, doing a quick recording on the Edison Standard B cylinder phonograph. I'm recording with the Canophonic voice recorder. I'm recording with my recording horn. This is 28.5 inches in length. It has a approximately 4.5 inch bell. It's being supported by a small floor crane that I built, and recording on an Edison black wax shaved and trimmed Edifone cylinder. Recording on the standard B cylinder phonograph, and just doing a quick recording. I got an email requesting me to do a recording with the recording horn rather than the speaking tube so they could see the difference in the sound of the recording itself. The recording with the recording horn will be fuller, broader spectrum, much broader in bass response, because the recording horn is capable of capturing the longer waves necessary to make a bass recording. I think the recording or the speaking tube itself works better for voice recordings, But this does give you the opportunity of recording several people. They can just simply walk up to the recording horn, speak into it, move on, the next person walks up. And you can still get a very, very good, loud, bright, crisp, clear recording using the Canophonic voice recorder and a recording horn. So this is Benjamin the Victrola Guy doing a quick recording with the recording horn. This is Sunday, June the 24th, 2012. It is 8:56 p.m. All right, stop the recording. Now, as I said, if we were using an Edison recorder, you would have to yell, literally yell, into the recording horn. Edison recorders just are not that sensitive. Whoops. They're just not sensitive enough to capture a spoken word or a spoken recording. Spoken being a relative term, you have to yell with you if you're using a recording horn and you're using an Edison recorder. Now here's the cylinder, absolutely covered with swarf. The amount of swarf is always indicative of how good, not necessarily good in quality, but how loud or how deep you've cut the cylinder. And the more swarf you have, almost is always indicative of a good recording. So let's brush or blow the swarf away. And you grab a swarf brush, and we just brush the particulate matter out of these grooves we just cut. And it's always interesting, looking at this cylinder, it looks almost as if it's been engraved. It is very clearly a loud recording. And you can tell by the definition of your grooves what kind of recording you've gotten. So let's remove the voice recorder, blow off the swarf, and we always put our recorder back in its box, always. So if the recorder is not on the machine, it goes in its box. If you drop them, you destroy them. Yeah, I mean, seriously, you drop an Edison recorder, it's never going to work the same again, ever. So we'll grab our Model C reproducer, and as I said, periodically, take a small brush and clean the stylus on your reproducer. It makes a tremendous difference. It gets globs of wax built up on it, and it just doesn't work efficiently. You want that stylus to be absolutely bare. It's a sapphire, a multifaceted sapphire. It looks very much like a glass doorknob. So you want it to be as clean as possible. And I just use a little dental brush. And you take a little brush, one of these things. And just brush the stylus, and it makes a tremendous difference. Especially if you have a cylinder that's now skipping where it didn't before, that's usually indicative of wax buildup on the stylus. It's not fitting in the groove anymore. It's now just skipping over them. So, in any case, our recording with a recording horn on a shaved and trimmed black wax cylinder, using the Canophonic voice recorder. And this is our result.
Good day, Benjamin Joe the Victrola Guy doing a quick recording on the Edison Standard BE cylinder phonograph. A recording with the Canophonic voice recorder, a recording with my recording horn. This is 28.5 inches in length. It has approximately 4.5 inch barrel. It's being supported by a small floor crane that I built, and recording on an Edison black wax shaved and trimmed Edison cylinder. Recording on the standard BE cylinder phonograph, and just doing a quick recording. I got an email requesting me to do a recording with the recording horn rather than the speaking tube, so they could see the difference in the sound of the recording itself. The recording with the recording horn will be fuller, broader spectrum, much broader in bass response, because the recording horn is capable of capturing the longer waves necessary to make a bass recording. I think the recording on the speaking tube itself works better than voice recording, but this does give you the opportunity to record recording several people. They can just simply walk up to the recording horn, speak into it, move on, the next person walks up, and you can still get a very, very good, loud, bright, crisp, clear recording using the Canophonic voice recorder and a recording horn. So this is Benjamin the Big Solo Guy doing a quick recording with the recording horn. This is Sunday, June the 24th, 2012. It is 8:56 p.m.
All right, so you heard for yourself. A decent recording, you don't have to yell, and just speaking in a normal voice. This is not possible with an Edison recorder. Using an Edison recorder, even a fairly efficient one, you have to really project your voice to vibrate that diaphragm. And remember, it's all based on air pressure and sound waves, nothing else. To get a loud recording, you have to have a loud input. Input equals output, unless you have a really, really efficient recorder, which we do. And you can see, as I said, these grooves are really, really defined on this black wax cylinder. In my opinion, the voice recordings are much, much better with a speaking tube. They're crisper. They're far more detailed, higher pitched. So I guess it really depends on your preferences, but I think if you're going to record voice, the whole idea of recording or making a voice recording is to make a good one. A speaking tube is the way to go, or a shorter horn. The longer the horn, the deeper the sound is going to be, because the horn captures longer waves. So the shorter the horn, in my opinion, the better the voice recording. And you can make a fairly good voice recording with a small witch's hat horn. A fairly efficient recording horn is the straight-sided little straight taper horn for the gem, a little black cone with a gold stripe on it. The Walmart transmission funnel actually makes a very, very good recording horn. It is non-resonant, heavy polymer, really concentrates those sound waves, and it works really well as a playback horn. So it just really depends on what you have. The average person is going to be recording with their witch's hat horn. With an Edison recorder, you have to yell into it, period. You have to yell. They're just not sensitive enough to make a good recording simply spoken in a normal tone of voice. With a Canophonic voice recorder, that changes everything. But as you heard with the recording horn, it still made a good recording, but in my opinion, it just is not nearly as good as using a speaking tube. I really prefer the speaking tube. Any recording I make of my voice is with a speaking tube, always. And there's a trick. If you want to record more than one person, if two people want to talk at the same time, you have two speaking tubes with a Y connector plugged onto the recorder, and you can both talk at the same time, and you don't lose anything. It's still just as loud on either side as it is with a single speaking tube. Speaking tubes are really the way to go. They make really, really great recordings. And the neat thing about the speaking tube that I built is you can pull the bell off of it and put the bell directly on the machine as a little horn. And with this machine and with the Canophonic voice recorder, I can use that as a recorder and get a really, really good recording. And it's actually kind of fun because it's so reminiscent of the cylinder tinfoil phonograph. But as you can see, this is just a tube. And you just pull the bell off and slide it on, and instant speaking tube with a built-in horn. And you can play it back through the speaking tube and listen to it this way. Great for field recording without having to carry an additional horn. But in any case, just wanted to do the recording, got the email. As I said, a lot of people are beginning to play with their Edison machines and make recordings. And it's a lot of fun, you know, and this is where everything started from. The basis of all of the audio recording now is based on this machine, exactly. It's really interesting. Even CDs and DVDs use exactly the same principle, but now they're using a laser beam instead of a stylus. But even a DVD and a CD has a feed screw to move that laser across the disc, just like this has a feed screw to move the stylus across the cylinder. The principle is exactly the same. It's just the modern technique is using a laser beam to etch a piece of basically mirror trapped in a layer of plastic. It bounces a laser beam off of it. It's modulated, red, and you have digital audio. The principle is exactly the same, but using a laser instead of a stylus. So, anyway, in answer to the email, you saw the result of using a recording horn as opposed to a speaking tube. Recording horns work. They capture a much broader range of frequencies, but in my opinion, nothing is as good for recording the voice as a speaking tube. So if you have any questions or comments on recording on the Edison Cylinder Phonograph, doing voice recordings, virtually anything at all, feel free to drop me an email to patrolguy@gmail.com. I'll try to answer any question you have as honestly as I can. It's likely that I've encountered the same problems you have. If so, I can tell you how to solve them if I did. There are some problems that I've encountered that just mystify you, you know, and there's no place to turn. It's trial and error. What works, what doesn't, and then you take it from there. You build on what you've learned, and it's a long, drawn-out process. And there's nobody you can ask, and there's nothing written down. And one thing you can't do is go on the chat sites. The chat sites, people on the chat sites will tell you 1,000 things you can't do, but none of them, well, very few of them, have ever made a cylinder recording. And they're full of advice on how to do it, most of it wrong. They've never done it before themselves. And so it seems pointless to me to even bother with the chat sites. As I said, if you go on the chat sites, you will never make an Edison cylinder recording because they tell you you can't. So in any case, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email. The patrolguy@gmail.com. As always, thank you for watching.